thank the Lord for being here.
That's right.
They told you to stop, you stop. They tell you to sit, you sit. Amen.
Amen.
For in Ephesians, it even tells us, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right.
Yeah.
So even if your parents make you mad, you still have to obey them. Amen.
Amen.
If you're an adult, make you mad, you still have to obey them. Amen.
Amen.
In Exodus 19:5, it says, now, therefore, if ye will obey my voice indeed and keep my covenant, then ye shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people, for all the earth is mine.
Yes.
The biblical definition of obedience in the Old and New Testament relates to hearing or hearkening to a higher authority, submitting to authority. In other words, to hear God's word and act accordingly.
Yes.
Deuteronomy 11:26-28 sums it up like this. It says, obey and you will be blessed. Disobey and you will be cursed.
All right.
Obedience is better than sacrifice. The Greek word for obey in the New Testament means to trust.
Yeah.
Trust is to believe, have faith, which brings me to the next basic, which is faith. When you're younger, you have faith, you believe in a lot of things. Some of those things don't even exist, but we believe. And I'm not going to say what those things are, man. But we have to have faith in these things. Even in the Bible says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. We running around here saying, we love God. We haven't seen him. But you ask, well, how do we get that faith? It's in Romans 10:17, it says, so then, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God.
Yeah.
Getting your word.
Yeah.
He'll start to strengthen your faith. You believe in him, and he's showing you in the everyday life what he can do. So you have the faith and you believe in him. Amen.
Amen.
Matthew 17:20 says, Jesus said, and I paraphrase, if ye have faith as a grain of a mustard seed, ye shall say unto the mountain, remove hence to yonder peak, and it shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible unto you. Howbeit, the 21st verse says, howbeit this time goeth not out by prayer and fasting, which is the next two basics that I wanted to touch on. Matthew chapter 6 pretty much covers fasting and praying. Amen. When you're younger, well, when I was younger, I should say, we learned how to pray from the Bible.
Yes.
And when I was a little bit young, let me start there. Didn't quite know how to say all the words, but we knew the, now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to save. And as I got a little bit older, they taught me the Our Father prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors.
Yes.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
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 That covers everything, just about everything in that prayer. But as I got a little bit older, my prayer changed just a little bit. I was able to get up and it's like, if you were wondering, how do I pray? It's just talking to said,
all right.
I said, oh, Father, oh, Father, I'm coming for your throne right now, Lord. I'm asking you to come see about your daughter. I need you, Lord. Whatever the circumstance is, and I'm talking to him, he will hear if he comes to see about me.
Yeah.
And I'm thankful for that.
Yeah.
And to touch on the a little bit more, the Bible says, when you're praying, you can pray in secret.
Yes.
It says, enter into thy closet and pray in secret.
Yes.
And, he will reward you openly. So your lifestyle should show that you spending some time with him. Amen.
Well,
you don't have to be out in the synagogue saying, oh, praise you, Jesus. I love you, Lord. You know, making a big thing. He's not asking for that. He's
right.
Spending some time with him. A little bit of time. Going to your prayer closet. Amen. Yeah. Your all prayer
right.
room.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then when it comes to fasting, it says to anoint your head and wash your face. You may think that's a little bit backwards, but it's not. Because you're not supposed to show anyone that you are fasting.
All right.
It's supposed to be done in secret.
All
you
right.
push back that plate. You expect God to do something, so you got to push back that plate. And you ain't got to walk around. I'll say that. You don't want you to be like that. He wants you to go on your everyday life as you would be as normal. Because
yes.
that's the time between you and God. You're supposed to be thanking him and praising him. Amen?
Amen.
These are a few things that I have wanted to touch on today. The basics for Christian believers.
All right.
But Brother Francis talked about building God's way through obedience and wisdom.
Yes.
And she talked about the different parts of the body and how they come together
yes.
to perform a job, amen?
Amen.
But she said as they come together, you have to make sure that there's a firm foundation.
Yes. All right.
Amen. So I believe some of these basics to be the part of that foundation.
Yeah.
Amen. That foundation that you can build upon.
Yeah.
All right.
Amen. And then when I think about the foundation and that the body comes together as far as to build upon.
Uh-huh.
But it makes me think about unity.
Yes.
And it says, I'll say just one second. In Acts 2, 1 through 2. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place.
Mama.
And suddenly there came a sound from the heaven as a mighty rushing wind.
Yeah.
And it filled all the house where they were sitting. Do you know they have to be in unity for that to happen?
Right, right.
Because one could be saying, saying something different over here, and the other one talking here. No, they were in one place in one accord.
Yeah.
Now, unity is the state of being united and joined as a whole, like the United States of America. And most of us have heard the saying, together we stand, divided we fall, or we are better together. Amen? And I'll give you a little example. For the younger crowd, if you go to a party and you see a bunch of people standing around the wall, you think the party is dead. But you go over to another party, you see everybody dancing, you're like, oh, this party is the mom.
Yeah.
Amen. But that's how we need to be. We need to be on one accord so we can build the body of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
For Matthew 18:19-20 says, again, I say unto you that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, again I say unto you that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask you, it shall be done them of my Father which is in heaven. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst. So come on, let's get on one accord tonight. Can I get you all to stand with me?
All right.
And when we get on accord tonight, we're going to begin with the clapping of our hands. Amen. So let's come on and start.